Good morning, children. Welcome back to our Google classroom. Which chapter is going on now? Chapter 9, Data Handling. Do you remember pictograph? We have seen some problems regarding pictograph. More problems we can do today. You observe the given pictograph and answer the questions given there. Okay. First column you can see some village names. Village A, village B, C, D, E. Next column, the number of tractors. One picture gives one tractor. So, using this pictograph, we can give the answer for the questions. First question, which village has the minimum number of tractors? Which village has the number of tractors minimum? Village D. Next question, which village has the maximum number of tractors? You can see village C has 8 tractors. So, it has the maximum number of tractors. Question third one, how many more tractors village C has as compared to village B? We can see in village B 5 tractors and village C has 8 tractors. So, how many more tractors? 3 tractors. What is the total number of tractors in this picture? Here, A has 6, B has 5, D has 3 and village E has 6 tractors. Total 28 tractors are there. So, observing the pictograph, you can answer the questions. Next section is drawing a pictograph. We can draw pictograph using the given diagram. Children, while we draw pictograph, if the simples are difficult to draw, we can use simpler simples. No problem. One example we can do. Following are the details of students present in a class of 30 during a week. Represent it by a pictograph. This is the question. So, we can observe the pictograph. We can observe the data. First column days, second column number of students present. Monday to Saturday, the different days attendance is given there. Here maximum of 30 students and minimum of 22 students. So it is not easy to draw 30 simples in a column or 22 or 29 etc. We can draw pictograph. So first we have to decide how many students will resemble by one picture. First we have to decide how many students will resemble by one picture. From here we can see 24, 26 etc. So we can take one picture is equal to 5 students. One picture is equal to 5 students. That we should mention at the top of the pictograph. This is a simple picture for 5 students. So, first Monday is 24 students. How we will represent 24? We know one picture is equal to 5 students. So, here you can see 5, then 10, 15, 20. Next, if we draw full picture, it will be 5 students. But here 20 plus 4 we should draw. Because 24 students are there on Monday. So, we will leave one leg here. We are not drawing the complete picture. So, this is 5. Then we left one leg here. Here we left one leg. Okay. So, it represents 4 students. So, 20 plus 4, 24. Okay. Next one is Tuesday 26. How we can represent 26? Here 5 into 5, 25. So we will draw 5 full symbols. Full pictures are here. So 5, 10, 15, 25 plus 1. So we left here 2 legs and 2 hands, and we draw like this 1. This is 1. So 25 plus 1, 26. Next, Wednesday 25, 5 pictures, 25 plus 3, we are drawing like this, 3. So like this we have to decide how we can represent using a picture. Okay, next is Thursday 30. There is no problem to draw because 30 is a multiple of 5. So on Thursday we can draw 6 full pictures. Okay, 6 into 5, 30. Then Friday it is 29. 29 we can draw 25 plus 4. So 5 full pictures plus 4. 4 means 1 leg we moved and we draw like this to represent 4. Next, the Saturday is 22. So 4 into 5, 4 pictures, 20 plus 2, we draw like this. This is 1, then plus 1 hand we draw to represent 2. 20 plus 2, 22. So this is our pictograph for the given data. Let us conclude this session now. Thank you, children.